What they don't know is when you go home and get behind closed doors, man, you hit the floor. And what they can't see is you're on your knees. So the next time you get a chance, tell them it's the God in me. 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 Peace, love, and light. Shalom, family. I hope all is well with you. How are you all doing? My name is Naisa Esther Ray, and today I'm making a video on if you're truly saved, how to know when you're saved, how to know when you're purified, how to know when you have the Holy Spirit. And I feel the Holy Spirit right now, shivers and heat and vibrations all around my body. That's how I know. However, so I recently did different prayers and things to get saved, and I wasn't for sure if I was going to be saved or not. And I know that when you're going through deliverance, when you're going through a process of Passover and transferring and crossing over into light and everything like that and walking with God, there's going to be a lot of things to come in your way to test you, and the things that will get you off your path and get you to continue to do certain sins or transcending, but different things that's going to, you know, continue to get you off your path. So it'd be to where you have, it's a process of where you continue have to be saved, or you continue have to go through those deliverance. You continue have to do those warfare and spiritual prayers, because there's different enemies, spies, and different things that are, you know, tapping in and trying to delay or stop your success. So with my experience, I had a dream where I'm probably going to be like Martin Luther King, because I'm always talking about I had a dream. But anyway, I had a dream to where, you know, I was playing the Jesus prayers on repeat so that they can be able to, you know, speak it and I'll hear it and it'll be able to be cast out in my dream. And I played it, and it was like I woke up probably like 2 or 3 hours later. But in the dream, there was fire all around me, and it was just like flames of fire. And I woke up and I just like caught my breath. I'm like, and I was like, at the moment, I didn't have any fear. I just was like, oh, okay, that's good, because I know that fire is purifying, it's purification, it's cleansing, it's igniting certain flames and things like that. But I, after a while, when certain things was happening later, doubt and fear start to seep into me, and I'm like, well, why would I have that dream when I've been doing everything right, when I've been trying to walk the narrow path, when I've been trying to connect with my God and everything like that, and, you know, I've been trying to resist the devil, resist the flames and anything of fire. And then I had, you know, something had told me, I had got a message from an angel that was saying the fire wasn't meant to burn you. It wasn't meant to kill you. It was to cut ties with all those things and energies that was in your aura field. It was to purify you. It was to cleanse you. So it wasn't to bring a bad thing. It wasn't supposed to, you know, frighten you and fear you. And at the moment, at the time, I was in fear, but I knew that I had to get up out of there for real. But I had woke up and just was like, oh. And then afterwards, I was like, you know, because you have these different things that speak on you in your mind or around you that get you to start to fear certain things when there's no fear that's needed. And the Holy Spirit is a spirit of fire, and there, you know, sometimes these entities and evil energies can play on you. It was like, oh, so you were fearing hell when you were little, or you were fearing, you know, different things and punishments and stuff like that. So it's going to play on you and be like, okay, you had that experience because that's where you're going, or, you know, you just had to experience that. But it was really just cleansing your spirit. It was really burning off the old ties, burning off the burdens, burning off things, bringing that fire purification and that intense energy of moving forward and getting rid of all things that no longer served you. And I felt like as soon as that happened, not only was I given the Holy Spirit, I was also, you know, given the knowledge and the wisdom that was needed for me to move forward. So I had a and also fire, like the fire wasn't meant to burn you. It was to free you and to liberate you, to get you moving forward. And the period of the fire is like the wilderness that we are once we get out of those periods in that captivity from the enemy, or those thoughts of, you know, bondage or indoctrination and all things like that. The fire comes to cleanse. And so Matthew 3:11, that says, I baptize you with water. Those who repent after their repent for their sins and they turn to God, but someone is coming. This was John, who was doing the work before Jesus. He was saying this. He was saying, I baptize you with water, those who repent for their sins and turn to God, but someone is coming who is greater than I, someone who is much greater than I ever was and worthy. I'm even worthy to be his slave or to work for him too, and to carry out his will, and to hold his sandals, I'm not even worthy. And he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Okay, so I was thinking of when I took that bath, and it wasn't necessarily a spiritual bath. It was just a bath with salt, and I was also, you know, saying different prayers and different things like that. And I felt the anointing or the Holy Spirit come through right here in my head, the fire or the piercing. However, it was like it was a baptize of water with the Spirit. And that night, I thought it was because I was being, I took a spiritual bath, that I was being attacked by this succubus. However, it was because right then I was being tested. Everything that we go through, anything when we're on our process of deliverance or we are a process of moving further with God and things like that, we're being tested a lot to see if we're truly going to follow through with everything that we've been taught. So, you know, I had that period of going, meeting that incubus or that succubus within the dream. Because, you know, and they were scared in the club, like, why are you here? Oh my God. And I thought my brother was walking with me, not knowing that God was walking with me and he was casting out the evil spirits, but he wanted me to cast out those evil spirits as well and see what if I learned now that I've got this baptized, now that I'm clean and made anew, what am I going to do with it? And I fell short because I didn't know what was going on in the dream. And so then, you know, now I had the period of the fire and the purification. You know, now I'm able to walk around in the dreams. I'm able to become, you know, awake within the dreams. I'm able to, you know, fight back against different evil spirits and demonic energies that may come my way, and have the strength to resist whenever they come and try to play on my emotions and things like that. So I want people not to fear the Holy Spirit or fear, you know, if I'm saved or if I'm not. Just know that it will all happen when it's supposed to happen. And sometimes when you take different steps to try to force it, you're going to be tested and seen if you're able to truly walk with that anointing and things like that. And I watched a video recently from Maddie Nottage, who is a prophetess, and she was saying how there's only one God. There's the Father, and there's also the Son, and there's the Holy Spirit. So there was a Father God, and then he had brought his Son, a part of him, a spirit of him, a spirit of God, to come down and save the land, save the people. And then when he died, he became the Holy Spirit of the ghost because of that spirit that was in him, but had recently, his body had decayed. His body was up on that cross and dying, but his spirit was unleashed across the land. So everything happened for a reason, so that others can receive and feel the Holy Spirit, to feel that spirit of God and that fire that was needed to purify, to cleanse, and to move you forward into whatever that needed to be done, and whatever purpose and passion and anointing that God has on you, and things that you need to be doing within your life. All those things happen for a reason, for it to be birthed through. And that was my message today. I hope that makes sense. I know I kind of was all over the place with it, but that's just how I seen it in my mind and just how I experienced it within my life. And everybody's experience might be different, but that's what I had today. This is Naisa Esther Ray, and I'm bringing light to the darkness and balance to the light. Peace.
Everything that I fear, praise the Lord. Worship Christ with the best of your portions. I know I won't forget all he's done.